If I could be honest, here in this moment, I've been so nervous to stand here with you. They're all here for us, and I feel their aura, but just for a moment, I'll pretend it's just you. Yes, they can hear us, but they don't understand. I have said all of my vows behind the curtain. I know they see us, but they don't stand a chance. I have kissed those lips a thousand times before this.
Amen. Now you may be seated. She's in good hands. Everyone can stand. Let's just open in prayer. Lord, we're so grateful for this tremendous privilege where two individuals can come together and become one, one in purpose. And Lord, you're able to utilize their life for kingdom building. We're grateful for this honor. And we pray even now, even as one will put a thousand to flight, but two will supernaturally put 10,000. I pray that this union will be potent, powerful, and that God, it will be saturated in love and tremendous affection as we bless you and honor you today in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. In God's economy, it goes like this: God first, others second, and you last. And if we practice that principle, you find that we will be so selfless in terms of our, you know, affection and actions to each other. And I want to instruct you and encourage you in that area. It is so, so vital that you carry out activities, be deliberate, and recognize that love is not a feeling. That's why it doesn't last in Hollywood, because some of those people are almost as stunning as you, money, that in Hollywood, some of those movie stars. But even though that's the case, some of them get married and then wake up the next day and wonder, what did I do? What did I just do? And somehow want to just reverse the whole thing. Ask Britney Spears, she'll tell you about that one. But the reality is that God designed marriage to be permanent. God designed marriage to be something that's going to last the test of time, where you're going to stick together with all the challenges that life will bring, and you're going to be an anchor to each other. You're going to be a source. As a matter of fact, I'm not sure if I'm seeing my wife now, but I know here she is. But I need to see her sometimes as I'm standing here, because I receive strength just from seeing her eyes and just to see her very presence, because it makes such a big difference. And when I'm on stages where I'm overwhelmed, all I need is my wife somewhere near the front, and I can do all things. And you know that? And so I want to encourage you today. I want to encourage those of you who are in the audience also, even as we're here today, to recommit and to remember your commitment. And remember, you know, remember your spouse, and be determined by the grace of God to treat that person with dignity. The Bible says, husband, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her? Will you comfort her? Will you honor her? Will you keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keeping yourself only, exclusively to her? So long as you go, shall live. And you respond by saying, I will, if that's the case.
I will.
You like that answer? You're ashamed. Will you love this man? Or will you have this man to be your lawfully wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance, to be with him in holy matrimony? Will you love him? Will you honor him? Will you keep him? Will you have him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Amen. Amen. Do we have the rings here? Do we? Are you in heaven? Oh, you have them. Okay.
All right.
Amen. Okay. Is that her matching ring almost? Otherwise, amen. Well, let's bless this ring. Father, we bless this ring, right, these rings. We bless them. As some would say, that it represent, Lord, this ongoing eternalness, unbroken wheel and time, so to speak. I pray, Lord, that you will just minister and just have your way right now. In Jesus' name, amen.
In a holy, sanctified manner.
and so greet the girl and welcome her into marriage and say, baby, how's my so go for it, my man, clear it away and mash it.
Tonight I'm yours. So tonight, the even though it's what we want, can't keep this up for long. But I just don't.